Okay, today we're going to do something a little bit interesting that's going to lead to another tutorial that does something even more interesting, but first I have to show how to do this particular thing. We're going to show some text on a screen. That's it. So it's in the documentation. It's not the easiest thing to follow in a way, so I thought, well, maybe I would make a tutorial on how to do that. Now, I've got a very basic project open here. You can see it is simply an island. This project is actually just, if you go to new open project, you can see inside of island templates, there's a meadow island. Did I just choose meadow island? I think I chose it. Oh no, temperate. The bottom line is I chose one of those little islands. It's got nothing on it. I've reorganized the outliner to sort of chuck everything into its own folder. Otherwise, it's an absolute mess. We've got all of our game devices that we're going to need to access. Everything else, trees and the buildings and stuff like that, it just, you know, there's a little, I don't know why they did this, but there's a little storage unit or garage here or something like that. We're going to, we don't have anything in here. There's nothing that is done. So we're going to have to start from scratch. So this is kind of a good starting from scratch tutorial as well. If we're going to make a map that has really nothing in it other than an environment that has been pre-built for us. Now, you can actually do a lot with a little map like this. We can make a maze. We can make a one-on-one. We can make a team-based one. We can make a capture the flag, all kinds of things. It's just whatever comes to your imagination. But right now, we really just want to show some text. We don't have anywhere to spawn. If we take a look inside of our outliner, there's no spawning device. There's literally nothing in this game. So let's get started with making a game kind of from scratch. So down in the bottom left in our content browser, we're going to look for player spawner. Player SP is good. And we're going to take this and we're just going to drag it up into here. This seems like a pretty good location to just put a spawn, and then we'll hit the E key and we're just going to face this guy to the mountains. Now, if you're wondering about keyboard shortcuts and stuff like that, I'm holding my right mouse button here and I'm just going around like I would be playing Fortnite with the ASDW keys. You can go up with E and down with Q if you want to go up and down. Also, you can just fly upwards or fly downwards holding the W key with your right mouse. Your middle mouse will sort of dolly. It'll move across in a strafing kind of way. Left mouse button is to turn around. So there you go. Okay, so I'm holding my right mouse button down to get around, plus using the keyboard. Now, if you find this really fast, you can actually just scroll on your scroll wheel up or down. I'm gonna scroll down, and you can see now it's really slow. If I start to scroll up, then the speed increases and it turns into this maniacal. Hard to manage, but if you have a really big map, you might want to use that. So a few little bits, tips and tricks. To select things, we're going to hit W so we get the little move gizmo. E allows us to rotate, and then R allows us to scale. We're not going to scale our player spawner thing here. So we're just going to put that here, and then we'll select it, and we'll make it invisible in the game in the details panel so that this platform doesn't show up. We don't want to look at the platform. Okay, so we've got our player spawner device, so we can actually spawn into the game. And now we want to add in some code. So this is going to be also a beginner verse code tutorial. What we want to do is we want to go into Verse Explorer here, and we're going to right click on our project, and we're going to say add new verse file to project. I'm just going to call this my game manager, just like that, and then hit create. And what that should do is it should start up Visual Basic Editor to edit your verse files. Now, weirdly enough, mine did not start up, so I'm just going to double click this verse file and it will open this up. So if it doesn't open up, usually it does. This time it didn't. Just double click the game manager inside of your verse, or if I close this down and I go into my content browser, I can now look inside of my project here in the content browser, and creative devices folder has been now created. And inside of here is game manager. Double click on that. Bam, you're into your verse file again. Okay, so this is just the basic code that comes when you create a creative device when you're making a game inside of Fortnite. So first thing we want to do, because we're definitely going to forget, is take this game manager and just drag it onto the scene. Now it looks like a bench with a computer on it, kind of thing. We don't want to show this in the screens or in the game, so we'll make this invisible in game and always enable the game start for this device, because this is what we're going to use our on begin with. So let's open up this, and we can see here we've got an on begin function. This is the best way to show text on the screen. We want to show something on the screen. So now that we've got the very basics out of the way, let's write some code. Okay, so two things we're going to need right away are some libraries. Up at the top, it says using Fortnite.com devices, verse.org simulation, UnrealEngine.com temporary diagnostics. These are all libraries of code that we can use within our code, but we need more. We need to grab the UI libraries so that we can show some user interface stuff. UI stands for user interface. So what we're going to do is we're just going to copy the top one and paste it in below, and then change devices to UI. And then we're going to take the Unreal Engine temporary one, put that in, and then change this to UI as well. If you're wondering how I know this, I only know this because I looked in the documentation on how to do something like this. And these are the two libraries that I know that I need. I don't know if there's some kind of list of libraries that we can draw in, but if you didn't put this in and you wrote the code, it would ask you to put something like this in anyways. So here we are putting it in. Okay, so the first thing that I want to do is I want to make a function or a method that creates my UI. We don't want to make our code inside of some other, like for example, the onBegin function, because onBegin runs right at the beginning, but we want something dedicated so we can call it from anywhere. So if we click a button or we trigger a thing or we pick up a coin or we eliminate somebody or get eliminated, we can still call our create this UI function. So this is going to be very handy. This is for good reusability. So I'm just going to copy and paste in the code. And when we do this, because they still haven't fixed every little tiny bug in this thing, or maybe this is just how it's always going to work, it indents it. We have to be very careful of indentation in our code. So let's bring this back by holding the shift button down and then pressing tab. We can bring everything back. We've got everything selected and we hit tab. Then what will happen is it will move all of it out. But if we hold shift, we can tab it back to the proper indentation, which is outside of the onBegin. So everything that lives inside of onBegin gets tabbed in one tab. Everything that's going to live inside this create distance UI function is tabbed in, and then so on and so forth. So this can't live here because it would end up in the onBegin function. So don't do that. All right, so shift tab. I know we're taking a little while to get to this, but it's really important to cover these little bits so that I can reference back to this in others and for everybody that's new that wants to get into Verse. Okay, so we're missing something here. So I left this out on purpose to explain how the UI will tell us that we're missing the UnrealEngine.com temporary spatial math library. So let's go grab that. We're going to need it. So we'll copy, paste, and it was spatial math. And that will get rid of the error that lived here. So if we say, for example, we get rid of this one, suddenly the canvas, and by getting rid of, I'm just put a hashtag that makes a comment. So it will light up the canvas saying, hey, did you forget temporary UI? And no, I didn't. And if we go up to the other one, Fortnite.com UI and hashtag that, make it a comment, then text block object becomes unavailable and says, hey, did you forget Fortnite.com/UI? Yes. So we can just put that back in. So that's sort of some error understanding. So what we want to do is put a text block onto the screen for the player. Now to do this, we're just going to create a function. I call it create distance UI because in the next tutorial, I'm going to show you how to display the distance from one particular place to another particular place on the screen. Kind of like the only up games that are out there, except we're just going to be going only out somewhere, not up. So I thought I would show that because there's only up tutorials everywhere. Okay, we're also going to pass in a text block object. We want to pass in a text block object so we can reference it later. Now, this is our own personal discretion. We don't have to write it like this. I'm choosing to write it like this because I think it makes a heck of a lot of sense. But you don't have to put in this. You can actually just set up the text block down here. What is a text block? A text block is a block of text that we're going to use inside of our widget. We're going to put a widget on the screen. A widget is just a thing. It's a UI. It's a user interface thing. And it could be a button, it can be text, it can be a slider, it can be lots of things. So we're going to pass in that object, we're going to make that object somewhere else and pass it in so we can reference it later. Now this function passes back canvas. So we create our function name, we define the object that's coming in by text_block. We've called it text block. You can call this anything you want, my text block or the text block, it doesn't matter. TB, something short, and then colon, canvas equals. So colon is what comes after. If we put in here void, then it would mean it returns nothing. And then equals. So this is now we're going to define our function. So UI canvas, we want to make a UI canvas, which is type canvas equals canvas. And then here we are going to define it. So everything in here is what is the canvas. Now, canvas is a place where no different if you're painting and you had a canvas. Well, on that canvas, you're going to put paint, or you're going to glue some things on if you're a little kid or something like that, right? So inside of here, we've got this thing called slots. Now, slots is an array. It's an array of stuff, meaning it's an ordered list of things. And the first thing that we're going to sort out is the canvas slot, or one of the canvas slots, the first one, which is going to set up where this thing shows up. We're going to show it in the upper middle of the screen. And we want anchors, offsets, alignment, size to content, and widget. These are all pretty self-explanatory. You might as well copy and paste these in because this is what you're going to use, but I'll explain them really quickly. The anchors are how the program is going to anchor our item. And because every screen is different, we've got the Switch, we've got PlayStation, we've got computers. You know, they're all got different screen sizes, and on computers, there's tons of different screen sizes. So we want it to sort of resize, which is size to content, set that to true. But we want to anchor this in. So if we think about it, each corner or each top, left, right, bottom, all has a position in programming. And in this case, the left-hand side is 0, the right-hand side is 1, the top is 0, the bottom is 1. So what I want to do is I want to set it halfway. So X, so it's a vector 2 object that's going to go in for our minimum and our maximum. And we want it to set it to 0.5 for X. So X is left to right, Y is up and down. So if we do 0.5, that means it's going to be 50%, right in the middle. And we'll just anchor this from the top. So we're not anchoring from the top, we're anchoring at the top. Go into the offset, that's where we go from. So in the offsets, we're going to set a margin. Now, top is 0, left is 0, right is 0, bottom is 0. But if you wanted this to sit a little bit lower, or a little bit to the left, a little bit to the right, you would put that in as your floats here. Remember, 1 is all the way, 0 is no way. And this is much more understandable for setting the margins instead of X and Y. It says top, left, right, bottom. So if we wanted to just sit a little bit below the top, we can actually put top. We can just put in here 0.1, and that will sit 10% below the top of the screen. Hopefully that makes some good sense. I'm just going to sit it at the top of the screen. The alignment is set up to be in the center as well. And then our widget, the thing that we're going to place on our canvas for people to see, because we just defined the where, is going to be the text block that we defined up here. Now we have to make that text block. And then we return the UI canvas, which is because we're going to assign this to a place, because we have to add it to the player's screen. Next thing we want to do is have this set up on begin. So when the player comes into the game, let's make something happen. Okay, so I'm just going to copy and paste this in. Now I put in some code that allows us to get the first player, which is usually going to be us, into our code available to use. Now we're missing a few things. That's why we have some red squigglies. And it's saying, did you forget Fortnite.com characters? And so we're just going to do the same thing we did before. Copy characters. And that gets rid of that. What's next? We're missing the play spaces in Fortnite.com. So all of these libraries are very, very useful. Play spaces, because we can access areas of the game based on them. So now that we've got those two errors sorted out, all these libraries are required for the code that we're writing. It's such a tiny amount of code, but we need all of these libraries to do so. So we're going to grab the play. Let's get rid of this, actually. So we're going to grab the play space. The play space is the game area, and that's going to be a fort play space object. Get play space is the method, and that comes from the play spaces library. Then we want to grab all of the players, and that is an array, and it's of type player. So that's why we say player. Play space get players. So that's just a method you use when you want all the players. And then we want to grab the first player. Because it's an array, we can grab it by using the zero of the array in the square black brackets of all players. That's the first player, and it is a type player. If Fortnite character, okay, so what we need to do here, because we don't know if we're actually going to get the Fortnite character when this runs, it's kind of weird, but live applications work in a way that it has to go talk to a server in a live fashion. It's not just running on your computer, it's running on a server somewhere. So we have to go and ask the server, hey, can I get this character? And the server will return a yes or a no. And we can only do that check if we wrap it in an if statement, because it's an optional return item. So if we can do this successfully, continue on to the next thing, and you can see how it is tabbed in. Okay, so if Fortnite character, which is just what I've called it, you call it FC or my Fortnite character, which is type Fort character, first player get the Fort character object. So because it's optional, we wrap it in an if. And then the next one, if the player, first player, which is the player up here, if this exists, then we can grab the player UI, which is get player UI, the player. Okay, so now we've got the player UI object that we can add stuff to. So let's do that. Okay, so I'm just going to copy and paste this in. So string to message isn't defined. This is going to be something we're going to do in a second here. Don't worry about it. But if we can grab the UI, then we're going to do some stuff to make a widget on the player UI. Okay, so the distance widget is what we're making, and we're just going to add that widget onto the player's user interface screen. Okay, so let's get that out of the way. Let's tackle what we're making. Okay, so we need to grab this string to message function. I'm going to put this in here. So I'm just going to copy and paste this function in here, and it is something that allows us to create a message object from a string. So I've called it string to message. You call it whatever you want. And this is going to take a value, which is a string, characters, and it's going to make it into a message object. We need this. This is something you're just going to be copying and pasting, because you're going to need this to put it into text blocks or buttons or something like that, because they all require the message object. So with that in place, this is just a self-made function. Okay, so to show the text inside of the text block, we're going to take a look at this code here. And I've got something kind of extra in here that I was going to show. And it's this line here that I've set up the distance text as a message object as an empty. Then in the next line, the distance text block, which is the text block object, I've set the default to be 0 meters. We can also, if we wanted to create something a little more involved, we can do it in this line here and then just take this distance text and replace that. So I don't really care about that, because I'm just going to set this up as some default text to be 0 meters. I'm not doing anything special. But there are these two ways to do this. So I'm not going to use distance text here, but I wanted to show you that that's there. And then I'm going to create my distance widget, which uses the create distance UI function, passing in this distance text block object. And then we add that to the player UI, and it should show at the top of our screen 0 meters. Right in the on begin. So let's check that out. So we'll save this. We'll go to the top. We'll click build verse code. And there's nothing to do otherwise. We're just, we've got the game manager here. Otherwise, we would be dragging it in now. And then from here, we just click launch session. So we're in the game, and you can see up at the top is 0 meters. And we've spawned off of our platform here. So that's how you add some text onto the screen. And if we take a look back inside of our code, we can change the position of this really, really easily. So let's change the Y to 0.5 and a maximum of 0.5 as well. And we'll align it as well. So the alignment of the text will be right in the middle. So we'll save that, go up to the top, verse, build verse code. When it's done that, we can end the game, wait for it to stop the game, and then push verse changes. And that should immediately restart the game. And we can see the change where the text is right in the center there. So it's right next to our head, which is kind of handy if you want to put some text right next to somebody's head that says something. So hopefully that's been a bit interesting. I think that there's a lot more to cover when it comes to making text blocks and buttons and stuff like that. So if you do have any questions, let me know. And I'll see if I can make more tutorials on how to customize this text object or buttons or whatever. But in the next tutorial, we're going to figure out how to sort out how far away we are from a place. So that's it for this one. I'll see you guys in the next one.